scalar product of two vectors. In that four properties completed. Fifth property, when the vectors are parallel, when the vectors, when the vectors are parallel, the scalar product of the scalar product of scalar product of two vectors is equal to the is equal to the product of their scalar magnitudes. Product of their scalar magnitudes. So when the vectors are parallel, in fourth property we have vectors are perpendicular, then a dot b equal to 0. Here in fifth property, when the vectors are parallel, the scalar product of two vectors is equal to the product of their scalar magnitudes. That means a dot b equal to ab cos theta. So two vectors are parallel means between the angle is 0 degrees. So 0 degrees means cos 0 value, if theta equal to 0 degree, cos 0 equal to 1. So here cos 0 value 1, we get a dot b equal to ab. That means when the vectors are parallel, angle is 0 degrees, the scalar product of two vectors is equal to the product of their scalar magnitudes. Here ab is what? Product of their scalar magnitudes. This is the fifth property. Next one, sixth property. The scalar product of the scalar product of unit orthogonal vectors. Unit orthogonal vectors I, comma j and k have the following relations. The scalar product of unit orthogonal vectors I comma j and k have the some relations. What are they? I equal to j dot j equal to k dot k equal to 1, and I dot j equal to j dot k equal to k dot I equal to 0. So I dot I equal to j dot j equal to k dot k equal to, we get 1, and I dot j equal to j dot k equal to and k dot I equal to, we have 0. This is the sixth property. So this is from fifth case by fourth case also. In fourth case we have, if angle is 90 degrees, we get product is 0. We get product is 0. Here also product is 0. That means here theta is 90 degrees. Theta is 90 degrees. So we get the product is 0. Here we get the 1. That means here degree is changed. this is from fourth property. This is from fourth property. And another one, fifth one. Next, sixth one. Next, another property. The scalar product of two vectors is. The scalar product of two vectors is equal to the sum of the product of their corresponding x comma y and z components A equal to if vector A equal to in three components that means A suffix x, A suffix y and A suffix z with unit vectors I comma j comma k means here A vector equal to I into A suffix x plus j into A suffix y plus k into A suffix z. And consider another vector b equal to I into b suffix x plus j into b suffix y plus k into b suffix z. From this we can write a dot b equal to a suffix x into b suffix x plus a suffix y into b suffix y plus a suffix z into b suffix z. So what is the seventh property? The scalar product of two vectors is equal to the sum of the product of their corresponding x comma y comma z components. That means here we have this product is equal to sum of the x component, sum of the product of y component, sum of the product of z component. If A is vector and B is vector, here A equal to in three components, B also in three components, we get the product also in three components. I comma j comma k are unit vectors. Here total seven properties. What is the first property? First property is commutative law. That means A dot B equal to B dot A. And second one, commutative law. Distributive law. So from the distributive law, we can say that A dot into B plus C equal to A dot B plus A dot C. This is the second law. And from fourth law, if two vectors perpendicular to each other, then we get the product is zero. That means A dot B equal to zero. And fourth property, the scalar product of vector by itself is equal to the square of the scalar magnitude. That means A dot A equal to A square. And another property, if angle between two vectors is 0 degrees, then we get the product is A dot B equal to the magnitudes of product. That means A dot B equal to, we get AB. That means cos theta equal to 1. And the scalar product of unit orthogonal vectors I comma j and k have the following relations. Means I dot I equal to j dot j equal to k dot k equal to 1 and I dot j equal to j dot k equal to k dot I equal to, we get 0. So last one, The scalar product of two vectors is equal to the sum of the product of their corresponding x, comma, y and z components. Here we consider vector in three components, consider v vector in three components. We get the product also in three components. Here sum of the each component of product. So for scalar product, one example problem. Prove that two vectors 2i plus 3j minus 4k and 6i minus 8j minus 3k are perpendicular to each other. Here we have to prove that two vectors perpendicular to each other. What is the first vector? 2i plus 3j minus 4k and another vector 6i minus 8j minus 3k. So we have some properties in scalar product. In that properties, from that properties, when a dot b equal to 0, product equal to 0, a dot b equal to 0, then we can say that theta is 90 degrees. So see, theta is 90 degrees means both the vectors perpendicular to each other. So when scalar product a dot b equal to 0, then the two vectors, two vectors are perpendicular to each other, or perpendicular to each other. So a dot b equal to. So here this is the a vector, this is the b vector. A dot b equal to 2i plus 3j minus 4k dot another vector 6i minus 8j minus 3k. So already we know that I dot I equal to here 2i multiply with 6i minus 8j minus 3k. But here I dot I equal to only 1. After I dot j equal to 0, I dot k equal to 0. So we have to multiply 2i into 6i and 3j into 8j and 4k minus 4k into minus 3k. Because here observe 2i multiply with 6i, we get 2i dot 6i. That means 12 into I dot I. I dot I value 1. Here 2i into 6i, we get 12. After that 2i multiply with minus 8j, 2i into minus 8j. So 2 into 8, 16 into I dot j value minus 16. So I dot j value already we know that 0. Next, similarly 2i into minus 3k, also I dot k we get 0. Similarly, so from that rule, I dot I equal to j dot j equal to k dot k equal to 1, and I dot j equal to j dot k equal to k dot I equal to, we know that 0. From that 2i into 6i, 12. into I dot I value 1 plus 3j minus 8j 24 and minus 4k minus 3k minus into minus plus 4 3j 12 k dot k 1. So here a dot b equal to 12 plus 12 24 minus 24, we get the value is 0. So here we get a dot b equal to 0. Then we easily say that two vectors perpendicular to each other.